Good morning and a very warm welcome to all. All those folks who are sharing in our Sunday worship. I must confess this computerisation and Zooming is all a bit of a mystery to me. I find it difficult to see how we can manage to do it all, but it's quite wonderful that we can do it. And as Sam said last Sunday, a great deal of thanks is due to Martin for all the effort and expertise that he puts into recording and preparing people's voices and for all those who are taking part. Our service this morning is being led by our minister, Sharon, and we pray for God's blessing on her and ourselves as we worship together.
Thank you, Fred. And it's lovely as always to be with you all due to the wonders of technology. Our call to worship is based on Psalm 96, verses 1 to 3. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord and bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all the peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Let us come before him in prayer as we give this service over to him. Come and celebrate our common home as we gather with the family of humanity, with the mountains, islands, and deserts. We honour the glory of God in creation. With the lakes, rivers, and seas, we come to the source of living water. With the land, its soil, seeds, and sustenance, we give thanks for God's generous provision. With the forests of great trees, the lungs of the planet, we will sing with joy and clap our hands. We join with the whole of creation, inspired by those who have gone before. We dare to praise and pray for another possible world, to the glory of God. Amen. And now we're going to sing our first hymn, which is Singing the Faith number 65, Sing of the Lord's Goodness.
Thank you.
going to pass over to Paddy and Chris now for our Old Testament reading, which is actually a reading for two voices, which is based on Micah chapter 6, verses 1 to 9.
Listen, my people, I need to talk with you. I have questions. I need answers. I have cared for you. I rescued you from slavery. I gave you wise leaders, both women and men. You need to remember the stories of who I am and what I have done. Listen, my people, I'm talking to those of you who live in the countryside. I'm questioning those of you who live in the cities and towns.
What have I done to you? How have I wearied you? Speak, the mountains are listening to you. The earth is waiting to hear your voice. What can I do? What can I bring to God? What does God want of me? What will keep God happy? What will keep God off my back? Would God be impressed with barrels and barrels of olive oil? Would God be satisfied with thousands of animals from my flocks? Perhaps my riches are not enough. Should I offer to God the most precious things in my life?
Listen. Listen to what God says. Look carefully at how God acts. Remember the stories of what God has done. God has shown you clearly what is bad and what is good. You are to do justice, to act fairly. Do justice in the home and in the street and in the marketplace. Do justice in your community. Work with others to do justice globally. Do justice with strangers and friends and family alike. You are to love kindness. You are to be generous. You are to share your resources and share them with a smile. You are to care for those in need. You are to walk humbly with God. No pretense, no bluster. You are to walk wisely and purposefully. You are to pray and wonder. You are to respect the earth. You are to experience and learn who God is and what God is about. Listen up. God has told you what is good, so do it. Do justice, love kindness, walk humbly with your God.
Thank you, Chris and Paddy. We're going to have our prayer of confession now, but it's not a prayer we're going to speak. We're going to sing it. It's in Singing the Faith, number 422. Father, we have sinned.
Yet we are true.
As you are probably aware, today is the beginning of Christian Aid Week. Normally, we'd feature it in our morning service, and no doubt, come the evening, there would be a Churches Together Christian Aid service. We would be receiving envelopes through house-to-house collections and seeing an advertising campaign on TV. This year, things are very different. There is an advertising campaign on TV. You've probably seen it. It's the one with the Reverend Kate Botley in it. But with everything else that is on our screens these days, primarily focused on COVID-19, how it is affecting people in this country, and how we must stay home, stay safe, and protect our NHS, you could be forgiven for overlooking the Christian Aid message. And of course, there's nobody able to call to collect those distinctive red envelopes, which are the trademark of Christian Aid. Instead, we're being asked to make online payments. Some people will, many won't, or don't feel that they are able to at this time. There's nothing wrong with the government slogan of stay home, stay safe. Doing just that is what is helping us get on top of the spread of the coronavirus. But imagine you lived in a country where staying home wasn't an option, where social distancing was the thing of dreams, where staying safe simply meant surviving one day and making it into the next, where the blessing that is free healthcare is completely unknown. Imagine how hard it must be to live in poverty or scratch an existence in a refugee camp, to have to bring up your children and look after your family where there is no clean running water, let alone soap, to wash your hands in whilst you sing happy birthday two times over. If we spend too much time looking inward at our own lives, perhaps mourning past freedoms, losing sight of the fact that they will come again, being anxious for loved ones whom we can't visit, but we can see and we can talk to, thanks to technology, willing this time away so we can get back to normality, whatever that is going to be. If we do all those things, it's so easy to shut our eyes to the struggles going on in other countries, especially among the poor and disenfranchised. Originally, Christian Aid's focus for this main fund and awareness-raising week of the year was to have been Kenya. We would have been considering the effects of climate change and the droughts which are making people's lives so difficult. Instead, because of this pandemic, Christian Aid have widened their emergency response, using their previous experience of the Ebola crisis. They are helping impoverished communities. If the infection rate of COVID-19 develops as it has done in the UK and Europe, then those living in overcrowded humanitarian camps, those living with reduced health resilience because of poverty, or those in countries which do not have the healthcare infrastructures we enjoy, will be most at risk. The death toll will be horrendous. I hope that your focus for prayer this week will be directed to the work of Christian Aid and to the communities it supports. I hope that you will be moved and be able to give even a small amount towards their work. I hope that you will be able to look outwards and not just inwards. But there's another side to what should have been Christian Aid's focus, and that is climate change. Perhaps it feels like it's dropped back down our agendas, but actually you only have to consider how much better the air quality has been. Well, not for hay fever sufferers maybe, but in terms of reduced pollution, to appreciate that humanity, the effect that humanity has on the rest of the globe. I'm sure you will have seen lots of videos on your phones and other devices about the wild animals that have started to come into the towns and cities where once there was too much noise and traffic, too many people for them to feel safe to do so. And we've all heard the birdsong. People have been remarking on it. Does it mean that there is more birdsong? Is it louder? Or is it just that we can hear it more clearly now and that we're taking more time to listen? We've all been told in the past that nature, given half a chance, will heal itself. But what perhaps has taken you by surprise, because I know it has taken me by surprise, is just how quickly it does so. We really are mere ants in the scheme of things. And we're powerless against nature, as we've been reminded. Yet, we have a disproportionate effect on the world in which we are a part. There have long been prophetic voices warning us about the damage we are doing to our planet and to our children and grandchildren's future. We've turned deaf ears. We have witnessed with discomfort how our careless way of living has cost other life dearly, our discarded plastics killing marine life slowly, our litter, the stuff we just throw away without a second thought, washed up on remote islands. We've witnessed it, but we've done so little to change. We have ignored global warming. We have denied climate change. We still buy produce from the other side of the world, produce wrapped in swathes of protective plastic, produce which we could grow here if we only wait for the right season, and relish all the more because we can't eat it all the year round. We have not reduced our carbon footprint until now, when we've been forced to slow down, to stop, to use our cars a lot less, our planes for only absolutely essential travel, to buy what we can get locally. And it's not just about the climate. It's about how we treat the other life that we share with it. We eat things that we were surely never meant to eat. We invade the natural spaces of our wildlife, and then we try to eradicate them from our gardens and streets, the very places we force them to be. We've forgotten about the maxim of live and let live. We've forgotten how to cohabit with other people across the globe, how to act with fairness, how to live to the mutual benefit of all. Sometimes it seems that it is way too vast a problem for little old me to deal with. We all feel like that. But you know, we don't have to change everything else or everyone else. We only have to change what we do. God tells us what we have to do. It was there in that reading from Micah. We have to respect the earth. We have to share our resources. We have to be generous. We have to listen to what God says. We have to look at how he acts and learn from it. It's quite simple. God has told us what is good. Before long, our present crisis will have passed. It won't have been easy, but it will have been a time for learning uncomfortable lessons. If we just go back to doing what we've always done, then what's been the point of it all? So I ask you, what change will you make that Micah chapter 6, verse 8 might come true in your life? That you know what is good and you do it. You do justice, you love kindness, and you walk humbly with your God. I hope we learn the lessons that we're being taught. Amen. And now we're going to have a Christian Aid video message from Wilf Hardy, who is the Christian Aid rep in Sandhurst.
Hi, my name is Wilf Hardy. I'm a Christian Aid supporter, and I'm also a member of Sandhurst and Yateley Methodist Church. As you may be aware, Christian Aid was set up as an ecumenical charity by the churches in the UK, and its role is to eradicate poverty in the poorest communities in the world based on scripture and the work of a loving and creative God. Christian Aid Week is the major fundraising event of the year, and this is still on this year from May the 10th to the 16th. Up to a few weeks ago, I was preparing to give talks for Christian Aid based on the effect of climate change in the developing world. The focus was going to be on how we can help local people build earth dams to mitigate against the impact of drought. But COVID-19 has dramatically changed everything. Although I do hope later on in the year, we can go back and talk about the impact of climate change as well. But COVID-19 is now hitting the poorest communities very hard, and these are often communities with a very fragile health service. Christian Aid, with its partners, is calling on its experience in dealing with Ebola to help prevent and delay COVID-19 infection. Such simple things as soap, clean water, and washing facilities are being provided while health workers are being trained to reach the most vulnerable. Specifically in Bangladesh, in the Rohingya refugee camps, nearly 100 health workers are now trained in COVID-19 prevention. Whilst in Nigeria, in the displacement camps there, health workers have been given protective equipment and washing facilities. But there is still much, much more to do if we are to contain COVID-19. So Christian Aid Week is going ahead, and the funds raised are needed now more than ever. However, local events have had to be cancelled, such as church collections, the Women's World Day of Prayer lunch, the Sandhurst Churches Together quiz. Hopefully we can reschedule some of these events for later in the year and continue some of the new activities we'd planned, such as collecting at railway stations. But Christian Aid is now relying on you to make a donation so that its essential work can continue. It is in these times, these testing times, that we recognise we are all in this together. But love and the love of God unites us all. If you can give anything to Christian Aid, please do so. And I'll just hold up the sheet here to show you the easiest ways of doing that. So you can donate online at christianaid.org.uk or call 0207 253 2269. Or call 0207 253 2226 if you want to donate via bank transfer. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you, Will, for that message. We're going to now sing our next hymn, which is Singing the Faith 663, I, the Lord of Sea and Sky.
I'm prayers of intercession are, as it was said before, from the Christian Aid resources. There is a response at the end of each prayer. I will say, Lord, in your mercy, and please respond with, hear our prayer. So let's pray together. God of abundant life, who created a world in which we could live and move and thrive, we see your goodness all around us, and we thank you for every part of it. At this time of year, we see the abundance of new growth, full of promise. We see the beauty of the insect tempting blossoms and inhale the scents of herbs and colourful blooms. We see that your creation is indeed good, as your word tells us at the beginning. We visit, or see on our screens, the amazing differences of the land's surface, where, even in the most difficult situations, life exists and develops. Vast deserts, huge craggy mountains, terrifying volcanic areas, huge forests cleaning our air, and areas, huge swathes of land, farmed and husbanded for our well-being. Not forgetting the great oceans, which supply another harvest for those brave fishermen who go to sea in ships to meet our needs. You have supplied all that we need, and yet things go wrong. We misuse your great gift. We are plagued by sickness, which we have not yet learned to cure. We have ignored your command to care for each other, seeking first your kingdom. Father, in this time of crisis in your world, help us to rediscover your love of creation and to reflect that in our own lives. Guide us and our leaders into your way. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, throughout your messages to this world, you have used unexpected people to encourage us to change our ways. We thank you for the young people who challenge traditional thinking in an attempt to get things right. In this very difficult time, we thank you that so many ordinary people have stood up for a response of loving care rather than anger and blame. We look for a change in the national outlook following the pain and grief which COVID-19 has brought us. May the generosity and care for each other, which is so evident at the moment, continue and grow as the weeks pass. And the danger of the love of money getting in the way of a better way of life be recognized and limited to the essentials of life. We give thanks and pray for people with great knowledge and education who can guide us in our choices, and for young people striking out for their future with hope. We pray that you will help those in power to hear their prophetic voices. Help them to see beyond short-term political priorities and business plans, and give them wisdom and courage when they face difficult decisions. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of second chances, we recognize the damage that we have done to the earth and the injustice we see in society every day. All of it fueled by worship of profit and possessions. We pray for the coming of a better world with justice, kindness, and humility at its heart. We ask that you guide us to be co-creators of this new world. Give us confidence to follow the prophetic voices, to stand against injustice to people and the planet, so that together, in your strength, we stop this climate crisis. We ask this in the name of Jesus, who taught us that true love is self-giving. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we ask all this in the name of Jesus, your Son, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And now we're going to sing our final hymn, which is Singing the Faith 487. You shall go out with joy. Amen.
Blessing. May God bless us with wonder at creation's glory. May God bless us with fury at creation's spoiling. May God bless us with courage at this critical hour. And may the blessing of God, Creator, Son, and Holy Spirit, rest upon us and on all creation this day and for the future to come. Amen.